Week number 25 of the trading week. Last week we saw a hawkish turn from the Federal Reserve, which was a little bit unaccountable from a lot of traders. That's why we did see a lot of profit taking on USD shorts, and it drove ultimately GBP, USD, Euro, USD and all correlated pairs significantly lower. Now the shift came amongst a few of the policy decision makers. Not a lot of them shifted, but most of them saw two rate hikes by 2023. And there was something that was not communicated to the run-up to that decision, hence there was a little bit of positioning unwind. What they didn't do is they didn't talk about tapering actively, as in they didn't give us a date, but it's a little bit of an anticipation of what data could be towards probably end of this year. They could start putting out a timeline when this will come through, and in reaction to that, dollar will considerably probably move a little bit higher as well. But what we're concerned about now is the shift in the narrative that this year so far we had the reflation trade, where you saw that yen was sold, CHF was sold more or less, and you saw that AUD, CAD a lot, and NZD were bought as part of the reflation trade. And that trade is about to unwind, and that's where we want to put our focus in, starting with AUD, JPY, and going into next week. We have on Wednesday, we have PMI data is due. On Monday, we also have some retail sales. So I'm looking for any of these events, specifically actually on Wednesday, possibly the PMI report, to start lagging into another short on ADJPY. ADJPY did enjoy a really good rally starting from the lows last year. I'm expecting this to come back down to the possibly the opening of this year, which should come around these levels here marked back to the 80 level. It doesn't mean it will start collapsing all the way back down where it starts, but really what we are looking for, AUDJPY and also correlated pairs that are a little bit more risk sensitive, that it will start climbing back down to be neutral for the year as the reflation trade unwinds. The same thing is true for AUDUSD, so you should expect AUDUSD to come back down to a little bit more neutral levels. Now it is already trading below as a yearly open, but there might be still some scope to explore the low of November at some point during the summer. Again, the idea is there's not a new fresh theme, there's no new trade, it's just the reflation trade is kind of aged, and people are starting to take profit and start moving money into cash during the summer to see where the next trade will land. So again, and Wednesday will be quite critical for yen pairs, as the yen moves really strongly with PMIs. There's a slight expectation that possibly the PMIs globally have peaked. If that is the case, then there's a huge leg down for EURJPY, easily another 200-300 pips. But if we still see these numbers coming in hot, then maybe you will find that this choppiness will regain, and we might even move up a little bit back into range. So I'm a little bit holding my breath on this one. Price action is screaming short, but would you want the data to show that PMIs have peaked? If they did peak, like similar happened in the back end of 2018. I'm going to quickly show you that without taking you too far down memory lane. So in the back end of 2018, we had this PMI peak, and yen pairs just absolutely took everything down. That's was similar to EURJPY, also an AJ, and all these other pairs. So here in 2018, we had this PMI peak where for most of the year it was trading fine, and then just the collapse came quite suddenly. So I'm expecting something similar with all the yen pairs just now. A little bit more moderation, but I feel like you're gonna make your bulk of your money when you look for setups on the short side throughout the week and throughout the day. The next big event I'm looking for is the pound, because the Bank of England is about to announce their policy meeting, and to whatever extent they'll start to become hawkish, or if they stay put where they are. From my experience, and this is a trick that I've learned over the years, it has statistically significance if you look at the London fix on the Thursday prior or preceding the BOE meeting, which would be here. So this was the London fix here at the price of 139.12. This is, I do apologize, the price of the London fix at the 4 o'clock candle would have been the 139.49. So I'm expecting this price, depending on where GBUSD will trade on Thursday, I'm expecting this price to act as sort of a rejection or a bounce if it starts trading above it, which is very unlikely at this point. So the most plausible outcome for me is to take that London fix on Thursday, use it as an anchor, and then when it trades underneath it, touches that level during the BOE announcement, I'll be looking to fade the move and expect a little bit drop lower. Some analysts are calling 136.50, which is probably not too, I can't really fault it, but really the magnitude of the move on the Thursday and Friday was really that a lot of long position needed to get out of GBP, and I feel like there's still some long positions left on GBP, and if BOE doesn't give them anything to hold on to those positions, you should see some significant drop lower. The same thing goes with GBP JPY. So you take your London fix from the Thursday, which will be the Thursday prior or preceding the BOE meeting, and I'm expecting one of that level to hold if the BOE meeting creates a sort of volatility and spike you tend to see during the central bank meetings to hit prices for you to be able to fade them. For the remainder of the week, I don't have a lot of views. I'm really waiting for see where sentiment is headed. S&P 500, we are going to have a quick look at that because it took a little bit of a beating. Mind you, that most of that selling was because of the gamma position unwinding, and stockbrokers will have to sell all the stocks they were holding because of the hedging activities. So that kind of panned out. Now you might see a little bit more downside in the next beginning of the week, but really there's no big theme behind continuously selling that, even though the Fed started thinking about tapering, which at this point, again, they haven't done anything yet. It's just thinking about bringing up a timeline, and to be honest, market was sort of sniffing it out already a few months ahead. So again, I'm looking at selling AUD pairs, selling NZD to some extent, and I'm looking to see if I can get into one of those trades on GBP and GBP JPY on the Thursday. On a Wednesday, I'm looking to buy yen against any particular pair if possible, ideally AUD JPY, so try to sell it towards 80 level if I can see an entry specifically around the PMI numbers. So that's what we're covering next week. That's all I wanted to say today, and I wish you all a successful and profitable week.